Hello, this is Radio Lewes, and it's Classical Phillipa. Another week has passed, and I'm going to start off with Anton Vivaldi. And what I have chosen is the concerto number 2 in G minor, and it's the first movement out of 3, and it's the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra.
Thank you.
You've just been listening to Anton Vivaldi. I forgot to mention which season that was, and it was summer. And I might just add, going back to 2006 and 7, when I was doing a business MVQ for partially sighted people, on Radio 4, they said in 10 years' time, which brings it up to now, there will be massive climate change, and yes, we're feeling the effects of it now. So it's amazing what the meteorologists can predict. Anyway, what a long, hot summer it has been. We cross the channel now to America with John Philip Sousa, and I have chosen a march from Flirtations with the Ramensky Symphony Orchestra. To make amends, I said the channel, we were crossing the channel, we were crossing the ocean, the Atlantic Ocean to America. So the music you just heard was John Philip Sousa, the march from Flirtations with the Ramensky Symphony Orchestra. My next choice is Franz Danzi. It's a concerto for flute, and it's number 2 in D minor. There are three movements, and I have chosen the slow movement with Andreas Algerman playing the flute with the Munich Chamber Orchestra. Thank you. just been listening to the music of Franz Danzi. It was a concerto for flute, number 2 in D minor. I chose a slow movement out of 3 movements with it was Andrew...
Andres Adoyan.
Yes, it was the wrong name. With the Munich Orchestra and Munich Chamber Orchestra. My next piece is by Cesar Franck. I played you a piece a couple of weeks ago, not Pani Angelicus, it was a flute concerto, and now this is a piece of an organ concerto. It's played by Michael Dupre, the organist from St. Thomas's Church in New York, which may mean ring a bell to many Westminster Abbey choristers. And the piece is, well, let us get on and play it. Thank you. You've just been listening to the music of César Franck. It was an organ concerto. It was called Pièce Héroïque with Michael Dupré, the organist, playing the organ from St. Thomas Church in New York.
That was one of three pieces for the grand organ, and that one was number three.
My next piece I've chosen is, I've never played this before, it's by Robert Schumann. It's the overture to, well, this is my pronounced name, Schönen aus Gosfaust, with the Wandsworth School Choir and the English Chamber Orchestra, and the conductor is Benjamin Britten.
Thank you.
You'd just been listening to the overture of Robert Schumann's Schönen Faust. That's my pronunciation. Sorry if I offend any German listeners. Anyway, it was with the English Chamber Orchestra, and that is that. My next choice is Camille Saint-Saëns, and it's, well, I didn't know it. He combined it with Liszt, Franz Liszt. It's Dance Macabre with the Philharmonic Orchestra.
Thank you.
you've just been listening to Camille Saint-Saëns' Danse Macabre with the Philharmonic Orchestra. My next choice is Carl Maria von Weber, and it's called Hammerstück, with Paul Lewes playing the piano and the BBC Symphony Orchestra. That's all I can tell you of that.
Thank you.
piece you've just been listening to with the piece written by Carl Maria von Weber, and it was called Konzertstück in F minor with Paul Lewes playing the piano and the BBC Symphony Orchestra. My next choice today is Mozart. And many of you will question me, why don't I play more Mozart? Well, there are many other composers that are around the world who compose just as much lovely music as Mozart, and I have chosen the overture to the Marriage of Figaro with the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra.
Thank you.
That was the Overture to the Marriage of Figaro by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart with the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra. My next piece I have chosen is by Peter Tchaikovsky, and it's Symphony in F minor with the London Symphony Orchestra. And so until next week, bye-bye, and I hope you'll be with me next week. Thank you. Thank you.